Tell me what those four letters stand for, or what those four letters spell. Beef, okay? So whenever you go to shoot, especially on free throws, hey, I'll put the balls down. All right, you got little ones you got to talk to, but I want to talk on the dribble from the high school guy. All right? Now, whenever I'm talking about shooting, I think about beef. You need to do this whenever you go to shoot your free throws. First letter, let me get to it. Alright. First letter, how do you spell beef? What's the first letter?
B.
B. Okay. What does that B stand for?
Base.
Base. Okay. When we talk about it, all four letters, you should have them pointing towards the basket. So I should have a good base. Your shot always starts from a good base. Alright. I got guys that come to high school from the junior high, and they got all kinds of crazy ways of turning their feet and all that. Amir, turning your feet and all that, okay? All right? The important part when you're shooting is you have your base, a good base, which is good balance. Your feet should be a little bit about shoulder width apart. Your front, your shooting foot, if you're right-handed, your right foot should be a little bit in front of your other foot, okay? Shouldn't be way turned like this, all right? Your base should be pointed at the basket. Okay, shouldn't be turned this way and you shoot like that. Now you gotta turn your body, twist your body to try to point and shoot to the basket, okay? So, first part is base. Get your base, point it at the basket, all right? What's the next letter in B?
E.
E, okay? What do you think is the first E stand for?
Elbow. It stands for elbow.
Okay, elbow's right, but before we get our elbow, we gotta get our eyes, okay? We gotta get our base and our eyes pointed at the basket. Can I shoot if I'm looking over here and I wanna shoot right there? No, not until you build that muscle memory, okay? Once you build that muscle memory, and a lot of people have seen Jordan, I can do it myself, and I brag a little bit, I can close my eyes and not look at the basket once I get that muscle memory. But you've got to practice it over and over and over, get your base and your eyes on that basket before you can shoot it. I've actually talked to him about it. A lot of times, the reason why he misses layups at times is why? Because he got his eyes down, he's not finding the basket quick enough. You gotta have your eyes up, huh? That's why your eyes are up while you dribble, okay? So, your base, your eyes should be pointed at the basket. What's the other E? Y'all already said. Elbow. All right? There's so many people that make their shot harder than it has to be by getting their elbow out right here. Okay? And there's very few. If y'all watch the NBA, there's going to be some people that have different shots. One of the greatest three-point shooters before Curry was Reggie Miller. And he had his elbow out. Alright? And Sean Marion, he had a crazy shot with his elbow out too. There's some people that make it work with their elbow not pointing at the basket. What about it? Alright, but the best shooter right now is Steph Curry. Okay? Statistically, he shoots the best. And whenever he shoots it, he's got his base, his eyes, that elbow's always pointed at that basket, okay? His elbow's always pointed at that basket. That way, your arm has no other choice but to follow where your elbow's pointed. Goes that way, all right? I can agree with that, all right? But your best shooter is Curry, all right? And that's what he does. Every time he shoots, that elbow's pointed at the basket, feet, eyes. What is the last thing? What's the last letter in B?
Oh,
L. All right? So what does that L stand for? Huh? B is for your base, which is your feet. What's the L?
Follow through.
All right? The F is for follow through. Or you can do two things. Follow through or fingers. Okay? You got your base, your eyes, your elbow, and and your follow through, or your fingers pointed at the basket when you shoot the ball, that ball's gonna go straight where you want it to, okay? It's gonna go straight. If it rolls off your fingertips, a lot of people when they shoot it, and I see Mari do it too, when they shoot it, they let go of it this way, all right? Their fingers aren't rolling, it should roll off your fingertips. Have a back swing. You see how when you shot it, it's spun? Add that back rotation. When you shoot it, your fingers should be pointed towards the basket and towards your target. Like you're reaching in a cookie jar. Like you're trying to reach over that cookie jar and grab some cookies out of it. Okay? Well, hope not. Just don't get caught. Alright? Come on. But anyways, base, eyes, elbow, follow through, fingertips, okay? Now, how many hands did you actually shoot the ball in? Two?
Four.
Now, it should only be one-handed, okay? Your offhand, if you're right-handed strong, if you're stronger right-handed, that's the hand that you shoot with. Your other hand is your offhand. That is just for support, okay? But you should shoot with that hand. And the off hand is like you're fixing a shot something, okay? You shouldn't be, when you shoot, turning both hands, all right? Shouldn't be shooting with both hands. That makes the shot go right or left a lot of times when you're shooting with two hands. It should be one hand, the other hand, your off hand, it's there for support. It's only there for you to balance the ball on that hand. But again, if you watch college NBA players, when they shoot it, they all get to that same spot. That hand is not turning. Okay? Now, a lot of people, especially a lot of younger ones, where their bad habits come from, the reason they shoot with two hands. Why do y'all think they shoot with two hands? Exactly, because you need more strength, okay? Because you need more strength to get the ball up to the basket, all right? And not to mention, most people, especially younger ones, especially this is one of the negatives that Curry started, everybody doesn't want to shoot here. They want to go way out here and shoot here, all right? It's a three-pointer, and they do this to try to get it there. Messes your shot up. You should be working on making sure you got good form on your shot. Once you got good form, then you can take a step back. As long as you're maintaining that good form, you can keep on stepping back. But as soon as you got to start using two hands or pushing it or anything like that, you need to step closer and keep on working on strengthening yourself, shooting it properly. Okay? We got it? Any questions? All right, everybody stand up. Spread out.
Stand up.
Follow through. Show me that follow through. All right? I'm seeing a lot. out of hand, a lot of the offense turns this way. Alright? This would be like you're trying to tap wood. So coming right here and shoot. Okay? Just right here. Okay? Let me keep saying it from y'all. Face, elbow, elbow. Follow through. Alright, keep it going. There you go. Come on, just like you shoot the free throw. Keep on doing it. Keep on doing it. Thank you. right? What y'all are going to be doing is y'all are going to be shooting the ball to your teammate. So, Jay, step right here in front of them. All right, look at me. You're my partner right now. Okay, what we're doing, I'm getting my feet right, I'm getting my eyes, getting my elbow, and I'm shooting it to him. Okay, he's going to shoot it right back to him. All right, now, what we should be able to do as coaches, we should be able to walk in between the lines without getting hit. All right, this is not a shot. What is that? That's a pass. That's not a shot. You'll never get it high enough to make that basket. You should be shooting, and you're aiming for the top of your partner's
Oh, watch out. It hurt somebody.
Right there, and then shoot to your teammate. Or shoot to your partner. Okay? If get your elbow on it. All right, let's try that. Ready?